Radio Lewes. Local webcasting for a worldwide audience.
You're listening to Radio Lewes, where the music matters, and welcome back to the rock show. Yes, I've finally decided to put a new one together. I've been a bit lazy the last couple of weeks and just reissued, frankly, because of a complete lack of inspiration. But what I've decided to do is just bring you a list of some of the great stuff I've been listening to over the last couple of weeks. And we're going to start with one of my favourites, of course, Blackstone Cherry.
People, people, your attention please. I need to tell on y'all about a new disease. It's crept right up from beneath our nose. And what happens next, we already know.
Stone Cherry's seventh studio album, The Human Condition, very aptly titled. It was completed a couple of months before the pandemic and the lockdowns. And I really think this pandemic has tested the human condition. That wasn't a single, by the way, just an album track, but I've been listening to a lot of new stuff as I've had plenty of time to do it, and they don't disappoint. It's just as fantastic as ever. Something else new to follow from the Dead Daisies. No Other, brackets, Baseline, from their new album Holy Ground, which was delayed like everything else because of the pandemic. Supposed to come out in 2020. There was tours announced, all sorts of stuff. It all got postponed because of COVID-19. So the album finally saw its release this year. Came out on the 22nd of January and met with global praise from both fans and music critics alike, including me. My next choice today is something that I sort of got forced to listen to, really. Not that that was a chore. For the first time in I can't remember how long, I got stuck in traffic. And for the most of that time, I got to listen to Metallica's Hardwired for Self-Destruct. This is Atlas Rise. We'll be right back.
Bitterness and burden, curses brimstone day. Domination.
Atlas Rise. Do you know what? It's been ages since I've listened to that album, released in 2016, of course. And as I say, just stuck in traffic and it came on. And quite often, I've got annoyed with the album because it's over two discs if you listen to it on CD. CD, I hear you cry, what the hell's that? Well, it all fits on one disc, so I don't know why they did that other than to make it more expensive. I'm not accusing them of that, but anyway, so have it all in one go. I got to listen to the second half, but Atlas Rise, I think, is my favourite track off the album. It was the third single from the 10th studio album, and the song was nominated for Best Rock Song at the 60th Annual Grammy Awards. I think it should have got it. Something else I haven't listened to in a very long time, but I've played a few singles on the live shows recently, is Sisters of Mercy.
We'll be right back.
Lucretia and My Reflection, the third and final single from the album Floodland. Peaked at number 20 on the UK singles charts. The song was written by Eldritch for Patricia Morrison, who he said always strikes him as a Lucretia Borgia type person. I don't know if that's a compliment or not. The lyrics concern the fall of an empire, war, and the consequent destruction of all other aspects of life. I guess another one is quite apt considering the situation. Never mind. I want to leave the boring stuff behind and go on to 1,000 mods. Latest album from last year, Youth of Dissent. And quoting from Bandcamp, In the past decade, 1,000 mods have risen from smoky basements to packed arenas, and from pioneers of the heavy stoner rock movement to one of the most promising European rock acts. In their latest breakthrough record, Youth of Dissent, they break the space-time continuum and perform a time travel to the glorious 90s, resulting in their best and most mature material to date. The best is yet to come. I think I agree with the best is yet to come bit, and I can see where they're going with the 90s thing, but I think they're far too good to lumber them with a 90s moniker. As is this next act, they are fantastic, and this is something new that I've been waiting for. It's Greta Van Fleet. Been worth the wait. That was Built by Nations from the Battle at Garden's Gate, the second full studio album from Greta Van Fleet, released this month, the 16th in fact. I've played some of the early singles already, But that was fantastic. The only criticism I have for this album is that the first track is very organ heavy, especially on the intro. That's a heat above. But the rest of it is fantastic. I love it. And there's one or two great videos as well. If you haven't seen them, check them out. Now for something completely different. Metal band Savage Messiah there with Under No Illusions, the first single which preceded the release of the fifth studio album Demon, which was released in May 2019. I think they're fantastic and I don't play them enough. I will definitely be remedying that. Next, a band that I keep forgetting about, and again I don't know why, it's Anchor. We'll be right back. Walking Dead from 2019's White Dragon. Anchor are an alternative metal band based in Catalonia, Spain, but they really are an international band. Singer, screamer Jesse Williams is from Bristol here in the UK. Female drummer Ra Tash is from Brazil. And guitarists, singers David Romeu and Fito Martinez. And bassist Julio Lopez are from Catalonia. They were formed in 2003. And I think they're brilliant. I just keep forgetting about them, and I really do need somebody to smack me around the back of the head to stop me forgetting this band. And hopefully that one will do it, and I'll play you some more as the weeks go on. Something now from Buck Cherry.
Came in time to clear my mind and think.
Vacuum from 2019's War Paint, which is Buck Cherry's 8th studio album, released on March the 8th, 2019 on Century Media. It's their first and only album to date to feature guitarist Kevin Ruttigan and drummer Sean Winchester. And I stopped playing Buck Cherry. Because they got too sweary for the... It just seemed to be for the sake of it, which was getting a bit dull. So it's nice to hear them back to their best. A band that's relatively new to me. I have played them a fair bit this year already. That does no excuse not to play them again. This is Hollow Haze. We'll be right back. The Upside Down there from the 7th studio album from Hollow Haze, Between Wild Landscapes and the Deep Blue Sea. They're a four-piece from Vicenza in Italy, and I think they're great. An album I haven't been able to leave alone to follow from the cut, I Am Vain. Debut album Valley of the Thorns, and I've just forgotten the release date. It was the 2nd of November 2018. I'm really hoping for something new from them, but I really don't get tired of the album. I think it's fantastic. Something next from a band I haven't played in a while, Beast in Black.
Come
Unlimited Sin from their second studio album, From Hell With Love. I think it's fantastic. I love that sound. I love a bit of power metal. That's just about it. I'm out of time. You've been listening to The Rock Show here on Radio Lewes, where the music matters. I've been Ben Fuller. Thank you so much for listening. I'm going to leave you with Devil Skin and Be Like the River from their latest offering, Red, continuing their habit of putting the title track to the previous album on the new one. Till next time, stay safe. Ta-da.
Radio Lewes. Local. Community webcasting.